Hello, this is Carol, KP4MD, and here I'm going to demonstrate how I used the 4NEC2 antenna modeling program to interpret some results of antenna comparison that was posted on YouTube by NO7ON, comparing a buddy pole vertical antenna and an Alex loop. And I've attempted to recreate NO7ON's scenario by measuring the images on the YouTube video. Here on the screen you see a model of the Alex loop antenna, which is about 3.5 feet above ground. And this antenna here is the buddy pole vertical with a counterpoise wire. And we can rotate it so you can see all the different components of this antenna system. And how they're pretty much situated. The distance between the two antennas is approximately 10 feet. Both of these antennas are resonated at 14.259 megahertz. The buddy pole vertical section is a quarter wavelength at that frequency, about 16.5 feet. And the counterpoise wire is of equivalent length. The base of the buddy pole vertical antenna is at 6.25 feet above the ground. Next, let's take a look at the Alex loop. The Alex loop wall cam is a magnetic loop antenna of approximately 3 feet in diameter. And here is the loop. It is represented by a 4NEC2 model of 18 segments in roughly in a circular configuration. Here at top is the feed point, and down here at bottom, this blue spot here, is the loading capacitor. Now, if we, again, I can go ahead and rotate so you can see pretty much how it looks. And this is the way I've modeled it, as if we're looking in the video towards the center of the loop antenna. Now, if we show the actual pattern, this is the pattern of this antenna at the frequency 14.259 megahertz when it's resonated there. And as you can see, there is a maximum gain of minus 4.4 dBi, and it is straight up towards the zenith. Please keep in mind that the gain figures quoted here are theoretical and are used only for comparison purposes in these models. Now, if we do rotate this pattern, you can see that it's not completely omnidirectional. There is a little bit more favoring of gain in the directions of the plane of the loop. And there is no really very sharp null on this particular antenna. Antenna modeling does indicate that this antenna will show greater directivity on higher frequencies and when operated at greater heights above ground. Now let's look at the buddy pole antenna model alone. As you can see, it's not a symmetrical antenna, although it is claimed to be omnidirectional. And when we do look at the pattern, we'll see that it definitely is skewed with the greatest gain in the direction of the counterpoise. So in the video that's posted on YouTube, the gain of this antenna would be directed away from the viewer, away from the camera's viewpoint. And there is a significant difference in gain here of about 3 dB or so, or 4 dB greater than the maximum gain of the loop antenna, but this is expected because this is a full-size antenna. But as you can see, there is also a significant null in the direction away from the counterpoise. At this point, the gain is minus 15 dBi. And here we have both models put together in the same scenario. It's important to realize when you have two antennas that are resonant in such close proximity, The presence of each antenna will affect the performance of the other. So in this kind of scenario, you really cannot make a clear comparison of the performance of one antenna alone versus the other. And we'll go ahead and show what the, first of all, we'll see when we feed the buddy pole antenna, we'll see if there is any significant effect of the loop antenna in the presence here. So let's go ahead and take a look at the pattern. And we can see that there appears to be a little bit of a skewing. Again, it's very similar to the pattern of the buddy pole alone, but it's just skewed a little bit over towards our right. And you notice that there's not a very, very significant change in the maximum gain to the buddy pole alone. So this pattern is pretty similar. And again, it has a significant null in this direction, which is pointed towards the viewer in the original video. Now, if you want to take a look here at the an interesting thing we could see is the current in the antenna. We're feeding this antenna, the buddy pole, but you can see how much current is actually induced. These red lines here show you the amplitude of the current flowing in the antenna here. And you can see, even though we're not directly feeding this magnetic loop antenna, it's showing a very significant amount of current that's being induced in it. And as a result of that, is contributing to the radiation pattern of this antenna system. Now, here are the two antennas, but now we're feeding the Alex loop, the magnetic loop antenna, and the buddy pole is the passive part of the system. If we take a look at the radiation pattern, you'll see a major change compared to the magnetic loop alone, where the magnetic loop pretty much had a bidirectional favoring of radiation pattern. It now is really favoring one direction mostly, and that would be over towards the right from the perspective of the viewer in the original video. And as you can see, we actually have some gain here. The magnetic loop alone had a gain of -4 dBi. And when having this buddy pole antenna present, it is actually increasing the gain. It is operating as a gain array, but it is only in one direction. So this has now become a directional antenna. So let's take a look also at the currents like we did in the time that we were looking at the feeding of the buddy pole. Here again is the relatively high current, which we expect in the low impedance loop antenna. And when we look here at the buddy pole, there is a very low level of current. You can just barely see a red line there, but that is enough to really skew the pattern of the magnetic loop antenna significantly. So here we're going to do an A-B comparison of either feeding the buddy pole or the magnetic loop antenna. When we feed the magnetic loop antenna, this is pretty much what the pattern appears to be. Again, it's almost omnidirectional, but definitely there is a significant increased gain over in this direction towards the right of the viewer. And when we switch over to feeding the buddy pole, there is that significant change there where you have the concentrated gain in the direction towards a little bit to the right of where the counterpoise wire is. So when you're trying to do an on-the-air comparison, one antenna against another, depending where the receiving station is in relationship to these radiation patterns, they may say one antenna definitely is better than the other, but it's all depends on the orientation of the antenna and where they are. And really, to do this kind of a comparison, you need to have the antennas separated far enough so you don't see this kind of interaction. Also take into consideration the directionality of the antenna when making those kinds of on-air comparisons.